Bam! Welcome back to Vampire Kisses, part two of book two. Some of you are disappointed with part one, not realizing that it's hidden underneath my failures. But you know, I only have an hour and 20 minutes to read through this entire book for a reading, so, you know what? Let's go. Doesn't really matter. I tried to crush these Smarties into a nice powdery form. Didn't quite work out, but, you know. I gotta stay consistent with a joke, you know. Remember, for our plan to work, you have to be on alert at all times. Cloudy and his gang have the nasty habit of catching people when they least expect it. He's too smart to confront me here. It would be too dangerous for him. I have a feeling he'll use you to do his dirty work.
I can take them on. I've got some moves.
Oh yes, I know. I've seen you in action. Get the one. Alright.
You must have heard that noise.
Oh no, it's all might. Don't worry, everything will be alright. And I slowly creep open the door. Guess who? Oh, wait a second.
Jameson, I could kiss you.
Who the fuck is Jameson? I don't remember him from the first book. I'm genuinely confused. Okay, nah, I'm not doing that joke again.
Is Miss Raven staying for supper? I thought I'd prepare goulash.
No, thank you. I've got to go home. There's been enough excitement for one night.
I think I'll walk her home. My cousin Cloudy has shown up in town. We can't be too careful. That boy has always been up to no good. I pledge to help you keep Miss Raven out of harm's way, however I can. Thanks, you, Jameson. You're a good man. Where the fuck he is?
Yowie.
Wait a second.
Cloudy!
X. What are you searching for? You don't know your way around town by now. Alexander wanted me to.
The map.
You know about it.
I don't know what you're talking about.
My grandmother had a treasure map in her mansion. Alexander must have told you.
Sounds interesting, but I don't know anything about.
I think you do. I can't imagine you keep secrets between such hot and heavy kisses. My hunch is you'll be able to get that map for me.
Supposed to find some hidden map and just hand it to you without Alexander knowing. What is it for me? Promise you'll leave friends and family alone.
Actually, what I'm really thinking is
When I receive the map and find the vials, I can help you become a vampire. Look at Alexander. What? And she's actually like, what? She's really all wet about it. So it's like, why doesn't Alexander just like nibble on her neck, toral, her cervical? And I was like, oh shit, I'm a vampire now. So I have fangs. It's cool. And then everyone else notices her shriek of lust and like, what do you mean? And those vials can make half vampires into full vampires. I could be just like Alexander. And for mortals like yourself, you could become part vampire just like me. And then drink it another time and become full vampire. Ooh.
I don't want to be like you.
Don't you? Then why are you dating a vampire? Do you really want your morality getting the way of an eternity with your soulmate? Next time I see you, I want the map. Then we could find those vials to get. It looks like Cloud Strife. Look at that. I could compare it.
I didn't see. There he is. You can't see it because it's black, but let's
look here. Alright. Hey, see that? They could be cousins. So I'll keep him for morality support.
Matt, you should go to the lake with your friends this weekend. It'll be fun!
Not without you.
Okay, welcome back to Vampire Kisses, part 2! October 32nd edition. I'm gonna show you why I couldn't do it on yesterday during October 31st. Okay, here. This part. For some reason, the recording just went all bad at this part. And just froze. And it just froze there. This video is supposed to be 16 minutes long for part 2 of Vampire Kisses, October 32nd edition. But it stopped midway through. It's like, wow. Part 3 is done, though. So, you know. Pretty good.
It pisses me off that I have to reread this entire section. Not because it's not entertaining, but you know, the more I read this novel series, the more I get enticed into the action. Anyway, back to my main point. It just pisses me off because this chapter is so long. And then after this, I gotta go edit part 3 and then go read part 4. Yeah, it's a lot of hard work, you know. Not without you, I want you there too.
That's so sweet! Raven, isn't that sweet?
And the main character girl was looking off loftfully into the other side of the earth. Earth the Raven! Huh. Sorry, did you need something? We're talking about going up to the lake for a picnic. We can swim, lie on the beach, it'll be fun. Wanna come?
I can't. Alexander has sensitive skin. He can't be in the sun.
Really? Too bad.
Wow. What? That's a drag.
Actually, it's fine. Alexander and I are just gonna hang at his house. There's a Bela Lugosi festival on AMC.
That's romantic. That's romantic too. How perfect that you share the same MacBray interests. Fun fact. I didn't know what that word was before the original recording of this chapter. It is like a word for dead things. There was a rather funny bit. There was a rather funny moment of me looking up the word alive in front of millions of viewers. Of me reading the description of it. It was rather great.
It's a shame I'm too lazy to do that because I'm rereading it. Actually, you know what? I could just give you a brief summary like I did for chapter one.
Nah.
Yes, but would it be? Well, what would it be like if Alexander and I had even more in common? What if I became a vampire hybrid?
And then over here we got a montage, a main character girl trying to transgender herself into the vampire gender, one of 37 million genders out there. I personally identify as a piece of shit.
Okay, this is gonna be challenging.
Raven, wait! I haven't put that on the grill yet!
That's okay, Dad. I like my steak on the rare side.
She's contracted several mold diseases.
Mr. Perkins, I'd like to volunteer to help you with the school blood drive.
This is reminding me of the plot for Fred, too. And she also sleeps in coffins now. Look at her. She's adorable. No one should hurt her. And then nighttime romances. They're dressed up as space aliens. Immortality would be so dull without you by me always.
Time will never pull us apart.
And then they don't kiss because I'm supposed to be there. And then yeah, she's attractive.
Raven,
the bell just rang. We're gonna be late for class. And then she walks out. The vampires. You know what happens when teenagers go into the drive-in theater. Things get a little bit
personal.
And watching it. She's adorable as always. He's watching it. He's like, so do you think Cloudy is falling for our plan?
Totally, this is gonna be an easy pie. The next step is to convince him I found the real map.
He's worried. Just please be careful. I don't know what I'd do anything if something happened to you. You do realize there's nothing more important to me than you.
What would it be like if I were a bit more like you?
What do you mean?
Well, if I were at least part vampire.
What did Cloudy say to you?
Nothing! I was just wondering.
Now you want to be like Cloudy, living in two worlds, outsiders in both? Why do you think he has come so far for those vials? If he liked living that way he did, and his gang would be causing trouble back in Romania instead.
I know, don't get angry. I just want to be more like you.
Don't you know you're perfect just the way you are? And then they cock blocked, they don't kiss, and that makes me happy. And then here comes Cloudy and his gang of... here comes Cloudy and his pussy. Yo, wait a second. That joke was supposed to be... because it's supposed to be posse, but no, she's a cat. Neat. Vroom. Oh, look at that. End of this chapter. I don't need to read this anymore.